A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 21st September, on the front page you have, in a big boost, government cuts corporate tax. So now the government has announced measures to boost the economy, and they include cut in the corporate tax. You can see here, corporate tax rate after surcharge will be 25.17%, and tax rate will be 22% without exemptions. So this is the announcement being made along with some other measures, like local companies incorporated after October and whose projects are commissioned before March 2023 will pay tax at the rate of 15%. Tax rate for new companies will be effectively be 17.01%, including cess and surcharge. And companies enjoying tax holidays can avail themselves of concessional rates even after the exemption period. Even MAT, minimum alternate tax, now stands lowered at 15% from 18.5%. And there's no enhanced surcharge on capital gains by foreign portfolio investors. Even buybacks tax on listed companies that had announced buybacks are been exempted from tax. And revenue foregone for the reduction on corporate tax and other measures which government will have to bear because of these measures is 1.45 lakh crores per year. So, central government has issued an ordinance to amend the Income Tax Act of 1961 and Finance Act of 2019 to put these measures into effect. Then next is no GST relief for automobiles. So, GST Council had its meet, and demand of the automobile sector was to reduce the GST rate. But then no GST cut has been announced for automobile sector. But another decision taken is about Aadhaar linking for registration. So, this proposal has been put forth. Here you can see several goods and services saw their GST rates changed. So here you can see in principle decision has been taken to link Aadhaar with registration of taxpayers under GST and examine the possibility of making Aadhaar mandatory for claiming refunds. Then next is draft rules to regulate social media ready government. So central government has informed the Madras High Court that deliberations on the draft Information Technology Intermediary Guidelines Amendment Rules 2018 has been completed. So these rules mandate social media companies to cooperate with the police in cracking cyber crimes. So the Madras High Court is actually hearing this case on about social media companies. The social media companies are being demanded by the center to provide details which they are reluctant to. They say right to privacy of their profile, their customers. So people as such who have social media accounts, they have right to privacy. So that has been upheld, and they also say that because they are, like, especially WhatsApp, because their messages are encrypted, they cannot provide those messages they can't decode those messages. So that's what WhatsApp also says. So that is them. Also, center is only concerned with cooperation between social media companies and the police, is what the central government has also clarified. It said that it is not linking Aadhaar to users' social media accounts. So this was a proposal which had come in news, but central government says we are not linking Aadhaar to social media accounts. Then this is J&K court panel to probe charges of illegal detention of children. So Supreme Court has assigned the Jammu and Kashmir High Court Juvenile Justice Committee the task of inquiring into allegations of illegal detention of children, some as young as 10, by security forces. So Supreme Court says these such petition raises substantial issues that children are being detained. On page 5 you have UP farmers to march to Delhi. So this is hundreds of farmers who will march to Kisan Ghat in Delhi on Saturday after talks between members of Bharatiya Kisan Sangathan and representatives of Agriculture Ministry failed in Noida. So they say that you can't get a vote only in the name of Ram Temple and nationalism. So they have their concerns, and the central government has not been able to fulfill their demands. They have made 15 demands, which include complete loan waiver, immediate payment of sugar crop dues, making electricity used in farming free, and pension for aged farmers. So these are some of the demands. So the central government has not fulfilled them. And then on page 9, you have Supreme Court modifies recommendation on Qureshi after government's letter. So Supreme Court Collegium has modified its May 10 recommendation to appoint Justice A. A. Qureshi as the Chief Justice of Madhya Pradesh High Court. So government sent two consecutive letters asking the Collegium to reconsider the proposal. So actually in a resolution dated September 5 and published as such too, the Collegium led by Chief Justice of India has now recommended appointment of Justice A. A. Qureshi as Chief Justice of Tripura High Court. Presently, he is the senior most judge of the Gujarat High Court, and now he will be made the Chief Justice of Tripura High Court. The Collegium does not disclose any reason for the sudden change also. Earlier, he was to be Chief Justice of Madhya Pradesh High Court. Now, they have changed it to Chief Justice of Tripura High Court. Already, we had one controversy regarding appointment and transfer of judges. And now, you can see this is another change which Collegium has made because of government letters. On the editorial page, the first editorial is a deep cut. So this is regarding tax cuts which the central government has announced. We saw it on the first page today. So it says tax cuts have enthused corporate India, but there is a fiscal problem to deal with it. So the tax cuts have been announced. These are deep cuts in corporate taxes and rollback of some market unfriendly proposals in the budget, which was presented in July 2019 by Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman. But then, whether it would be beneficial or not, that depends on how the government, how the economy gets revived through it. So it says, here you can see whether tax cuts leave the government and the fisc is the question. Like it will affect the government's fiscal discipline because they have to keep fiscal deficit in control, and it will be a huge loss to the government because of these tax cuts. So that is the question being posed to. Then next is a rural stimulus. So this is regarding putting more money in the hands of the people through increasing wages on the Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act. So it says putting more money in the hands of rural households will stir up the economy. So this is appreciated. The lead article, One People, Many Countries. So this is regarding how Indian American gathering in Houston will be an unlikely reminder of the futility of the claims of ultranationalism. So again, the Trump administration is against immigrants. And these are immigrants, Indian origin people in America, Indian Americans who are being addressed. And then this is an independent fiscal watchdog for Parliament. So at Parliament Budget Office, as such, a Parliament Budget Office, it says, can help drive smarter, more focused debate in the media with the electorate. So what is being proposed here in this article is a fiscal watchdog for Parliament. A Parliament Budget Office. If you look into how the budget is being implemented and how fiscal discipline is maintained. Then on Saturdays on the op-ed page, you have Ground Zero coverage. So here today it is regarding Vemnand Lake in Maradu, Kerala. It says a lake in the crosshairs of development. So residents of four high-rise apartment complexes along the Vemnand Lake in Maradu, Kerala, protesting against a recent Supreme Court order to raise down their homes, because it is flagrant violation of coastal regulatory zones guidelines. So this is regarding this issue. On page 13, you have LNG deal to kickstart Modi's American tour. So officials say that oil gas purchases will re-energize ties between India and USA. So that's what Prime Minister Narendra Modi is going to kick off his visit to US with for Howdy Modi meet. So this actually is USA has also been asking India to raise its purchases from it so that the trade deficit can be narrowed, and India has requirements for oil and gas. So we have been increasing our imports. You can see LNG imports from US to India have been rising over the years as shown. And below you have India Mongolia to explore space together. So this is India and Mongolia who have signed an MOU on space cooperation and disaster management. So this will provide new dimension to India Mongolia strategic partnership. On international page, you have Pakistan activist flees to US, seeks political asylum. So So this is Gulala Ismail. She has been campaigning to empower Pakistani girls, and she has won many international awards and recognitions for her work as Pakistan's foremost activist. But recently, when she spoke out against sexual violence and disappearances allegedly carried out by the army in northwest Pakistan, her fortunes have changed. The 32-year-old says that she fears for her life, and she's gone to US seeking political asylum. Then this is Hong Kong police tortured protesters, alleges Amnesty. So Amnesty International has accused Hong Kong police of torturing and other manhandling and abuses of the pro-democracy protesters. So this is the allegation being made. And below you have US students seek climate action. So this is the largest climate change protest in the US, which took place with students and young people coming out. So all across 50 US states, students are coming out to demand action to prevent climate change. So this is Greta Thunberg, the 16-year-old from Sweden, who began these weekly Friday protests outside Swedish parliament in 2018 August and has become the face of these protests. She has participated in a rally in Lower Manhattan in USA too. So children should come out is what she's doing, because climate change is a threat for the future. So the children, you can see school students, they have been allowed to skip classes to attend the protest if they have their parents' permission. So this is being done. Then on business page, you have the coverage of the first page news that how surcharge relief may improve sentiment and boost earnings. So the government has waived the levy for all categories of investors, and surcharge is not applicable on foreign portfolio investments too, on sale of securities in the derivative segment. So this is being appreciated, and this is a comparison being shown of corporate tax rate across various countries with what India has. And below you have firms can use CSR funds for R&D. So this is regarding corporate social responsibility. So it is mandatory for companies to corporate India to have corporate social responsibility spending. So this spending now, because it has been seen that companies are in a crisis, it has been said that government has changed the norms, and because it is like CSR, corporate social responsibility spending, generally in education sector, health sector, for benefit of the population, for the lower strata of the population. But now the government says that corporate India can use their mandatory CSR spending for investment in publicly funded incubators and contribute to research efforts in science, technology, medicine and engineering. So this, it says firms can use CSR funds for R&D, and they say this will help meet monetary needs for research. So this is a decision being taken. Then on the last page, you don't have any news, there's ad. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asha.com. Thank you.